Hi guys, this is Ton from Tigerlink. Welcome back to another tutorial video. And in this video, we're going to be going through how to pair and set up a reflective photocell on the BTA control board from BFT. Let's start with wiring. Additionally, you can look at the wiring diagram on our website as well. That's the terminal. It's removable. And it goes in that way, but to make your life easier, remove it when you do the wiring. Same goes with the terminal on the BFT control board. They are removable. And for this photocell, you will need the orange block for power and the red block for the sensor. The terminal will go in that way. So the bottom two terminal will go into 50 and 51, either way, because there's non-polarity. It's an AC current from the BFT control board. So the bottom two goes into 50 and 51. Then if you look at the label here, the third terminal from the bottom is normally closed, and the fifth terminal from the bottom is common. And those are the terminals that we'll use. So the third terminal, which will be the red wire, will go into 72, and the fifth terminal, which is the common, will go into 70. And the additional step that you got to do is you either cut the jumper wire connecting 70 and 72, or you unscrew and remove this wire. Otherwise, your photocell will not work. However, if you decide to remove your photocell, you have to put this jumper back on, otherwise the motor will not move. Remove the wire from 70 and 72. Connect the red wire, which is connecting to the third terminal normally closed on the photocell, to 72. Connect the black wire, which is connecting to the common fifth terminal, to 70. Plug your terminal back in. Red light on the reflective sensor shows that the beam is broken. So when you see red light, the motor will not move. Once you put a reflector on, when the light becomes green, that means the beam is connected and you can trigger the motor. This is when the gate is closing. And the factory setting for the factory configuration, the photocell will also work during opening. This is opening. Once the beam is broken, the gate will stop. And we'll continue again. I'll show you how to change it to the configuration that the photocell will only work when the gate is closing. To make the photocell or the safety sensor only work during closing, use a screwdriver and flick the dip switch number 5 up. Two lights will start flashing. Press and hold S2 until they go off. After you flick up the dip switch number 5, the safety sensor will not work at all during opening. So this is opening. It doesn't matter if I remove the reflector, the gate will still continue moving. The safety sensor will only work when the gate is closing. So if the gate is closing and I break the beam, the gate will go back by itself immediately to the closing position, to the opening position, I mean. Thank you so much for watching. If you'd like to see more tech tip or tutorial video, feel free to subscribe to our channel. If you'd like to see more of our products, you can come down to our showroom in Preston, Melbourne, or you can click the link below to visit our website at tigerlink.com.au. Once again, if you have any questions for me or the team, feel free to email us at sales@tigerlink.com.au and see you in the next tech tip video.